And looks like we're getting set to come to green here. Bradshaw and Whitener in row one. Lloyd and Buckingham in row two. Carpenter and Crane in row three. Henderson in row four. They clear them out. Get ready to pull the trigger and smash the loud pedal here in qualifying heat race. Number one, eyes on them off. Turn number four. Green flag waves. Here we go. They drag race into turn one. Who's it going to be? The Super Duck or Too Cool? Is that work off turn number two down the back straightaway? It'll be Too Cool, Mark Whitener. He'll jump to the early race lead. Donald Bradshaw going to be in second. Shannon Buckingham third. Ivan Lloyd Jr. fourth in that fourth and final transfer spot here on the opening lap. One down, nine remain. Buckingham trying to look to the inside of the Super Duck as they work off two down the back straightaway. Not able to make a move. Lloyd going to hold down that fourth spot right now as Brandon Carpenter challenging Lloyd now for that fourth position, but not able to make the move at this point. Buckingham takes a peek beneath Super Duck for the runner-up spot in the one, but not able to shake him right here. As we'll have three laps scored this time by, there'll be three down, seven to go in qualifying heat number one. And it is all Middleburg, Florida's Mark Whitener at this point. Here in the early going of this one. One lap shy of the midpoint. Whitener with it in control. Bradshaw rides in third, Buckingham fourth, Lloyd is fifth. Then it's Carpenter, Henderson, and Crane. Halfway to the house, five down, five remain here in this one. And Mark Whitener looking high, wide, and handsome as he works the middle of the Screven Motor Speedway racing surface down Main Street here and put lap number six up on the board. Battle for third to 58 of Ivan and Lloyd trying to work beneath Shannon Buckingham. Buckingham slips up the banking. Lloyd, no. Buckingham with a good run off the top side of turn two. Hangs on to the third spot. As we'll have a lucky seven scored right there. Seven down, three remain. Seven down, three remain here in a qualifying heat number one. Yes, we'll have two laps to go this time for Mark Whitener in the deuce. Whitener, if he wins it, he will be the pole sitter for the 18th annual Rebel Yell as Lloyd trying to work beneath Buckingham now. They're side by side for third as the white flag will be displayed. One lap to go in qualifying heat number one. It's Whitener's race to lose here at this point. As they work off two down the back straightaway, Lloyd and Buckingham still battle for the third spot. But your winner fixing to make its way off turn number four. Middleburg, Florida's Mark Whitener, the winner of qualifying heat number one. Donald Bradshaw going to come home in second. Who's it going to be for third? Shannon Buckingham going to get third. Ivan and Lloyd will come home in fourth.
Who was that for that?
You brought this on the pod yourself. You asked for it. Don't try to leave me.
It's all good.
Green getting ready to wave, and I don't believe that start's going to go. They'll bring that back, re-rack them, and try it again. Green's going to wave. Here we go in Super Late Model Heat number two. They'll fire him off into turn number one. Lancaster, South Carolina's Josh Langley going to jump out to the early lead and caution back out. Did not like the way at front. And Green's going to wave. Hopefully third time's going to be the charm here as they race off into turn number one. Dennis Rambo Franklin trying to jump out to the early race lead. Brian Carner battling to the outside of Josh Langley down into turn three. Langley, though, nice and smooth across the bottom, going to grab the second position. Move Carner back to third. Scott Shirey up between cars in the 10, trying to get the third position up from Carner now as Brent Dixon battling right there as well. And the eight of Craig Vosbergen rides in six, close quarter action. And Langley out of shape up in turn number four. And it looked like something may have broke on the seven machine of Josh Langley. Caution flag is out. In tow of a Dennis Franklin, third place finisher at Swainsboro last night, in charge of the restart off four. And here we go. Franklin will lead them into turn number one there. Connor second, Shirey third, Dixon fourth, and Vosburgh get in fifth. It's the field battling down the back straight away. They'll set them down into turn number three. Dixon trying to work beneath Shirey for the third spot, not able to get the job done up to this point. As Dennis Franklin continues to lead the way out front. Horns up the Longhorn out in front of this one here in qualifying heat number two. Three laps in the books, three down. Field working lap number seven. Rambo continues to lead the way with the double sevens of Brian Connor in second. Scott Shirey, the Swansea, South Carolina native, holding off Elberton, Georgia's Brent Dixon for that third spot for right now. While Craig Vosbergen rides in fifth, one spot on the outside, looking in right here. As we get ready to cross the halfway marker, there'll be five down, five to go here in Super Late Model qualifying heat number two. And it is all Dennis Franklin out in front at this point in the contest. But Brian Connor trying to slowly reel in Rambo here as we have worked our way past the midpoint. Six down, four to go. Franklin showing the way. Connor still in second, Shirey third, Dixon fourth, and Vosburgh in fifth. As the laps will wind down here in this one, we'll have two to go this time, two to go, and Connor has closed in on Rambo for the top spot as they race off into turn number one. Connor closes up on Rambo's rear quarter panel, left rear quarter panel into three. White flag about to be displayed. One lap's going to settle it right here. Franklin and Connor. Connor got just a bit out of shape right there. That may be the advantage that Rambo needs as they set him down into turn number three. And off of turn number four, it'll be Gaffney, South Carolina's Dennis Rambo. Franklin, the winner of heat number two. Brian Connor will finish in second. Third will be Scott Shirey. Fourth will go to Brent Dixon. Fifth will be Craig Vosbergen. Eyes on him here off of turn number four. Triple digits across the front row. 116 and 101 to bring him to green. Here we go. They'll drag race into turn number one off of turn two. Overton going to slide up, grab the race lead. Roberts going to be in second as they set him down into turn number three. Ross Bales rides in third, battle for that fourth spot. As the 121 of Pearson Lee Williams wins it from Brian Ligon momentarily. Last night, he got had a flat tire on lap 20 and charged his way back up to second, was fixing to possibly take the lead, and broke a drive shaft with about five laps remaining at Swainsboro last night. Did Brandon Overton, but he is looking high, wide, and handsome here in the early going of Super Late Model Heat number three. Overton the leader, Roberts is second, Bales is third, Williams fourth, then Ligon, Rogers, and Skelton. Overton, he shows the way. Yes, Williams starting to get some pressure from Ligon for that fourth and final transfer spot through turns one and two. We're going to be halfway to the house right here this time by five down, five to go in qualifying heat number three. And it is all Brandon Overton out in front. Young man that has undoubtedly had a dream season so far in 2017 with a dream team. And looking good here at Scriven Motor Speedway tonight in his qualifying heat race for the Rebel Yell. Roberts in second. Bales is third as Williams has his hands full with Ligon for that fourth and final transfer spot. As Overton will put lucky lap number seven on the board. And Overton setting a torrid pace in this one. He was the overall top qualifier. About to put the 0F of Farrell Skelton a lap down here in the qualifying heat with two to go. It is all Brandon Overton. I mean, he is putting a show on here, folks. White flag about to be displayed. One to go in qualifying heat number three. Overton on the point. Roberts in second. Bales holds down that third spot. As they roll off turn number four, here he comes for the final time. It'll be Evans, Georgia's Brandon Overton, the winner of qualifying heat number three. Casey Roberts going to come home in second. Third will be Ross Bales. Who's it going to be for fourth? Pearson Lee Williams will come home in fourth. Brian Ligon will finish in fifth. As we are getting set to bring them to green right here off of turn number four. Green flag's gonna wave. And here we go. Down the back straightaway, they'll go into turn number three. Kid Quick, Zach Mitchell has jumped to their early race lead here in this one. Steve Case Boats got his hands full with Donald McIntosh. They battle for second and third to 24D. Michael Brown looks beneath McIntosh, who's won three in a row coming into tonight's action. They're thinking about it. They'll make it three wide, and look at Brown. He is up between cars and goes from fourth to second right there. Shuffles McIntosh and Case Boat back to third and fourth. What a daring move right there. And we'll have a hat trick scored this time. Three down, seven to go. But all that action going on behind Kid Quick, entering South Carolina, Zach Mitchell showing away. If he wins this one, he will start in position number four, does the winner of heat number four. And he's got her well in hand right now, but McIntosh trying to battle back on Brown, but nothing doing. One lap shy of the midpoint in the fourth and final Shapers Oil Southern Nationals qualifying heat race of the night. Mitchell with about three quarters of a straightaway lead over second place running Michael Brown. Donald McIntosh holds down third. Steve Case Bolt in the fourth and final transfer spot right now. Yes, we'll put lap number six on the board. Six down, four to go. Four, Kid Quick, Zach Mitchell. Lucky number seven about to go up, and Mitchell just getting better and better as this one goes on. Almost a full straightaway lead over second place running Michael Brown. As the laps are winding down in this one, when Mitchell crosses this time, there will be two laps to go as he'll have to negotiate the slower car of Jason Walker and does down into turn number one. We've got less than two to go now. Mitchell brings that machine down off turn number four to the white flag. One lap to settle it in the fourth and final qualifying heat race of the night. Case Boat trying to get racy with McIntosh, but not able to make a move. As your leader in turn number three, he's off of turn number four. Entering South Carolina's Kid Quick, Zach Mitchell, winner of qualifying heat number four. Michael Brown will come home in second. Third will be Donald McIntosh. Steve Case Boat will finish in fourth. Then it will be Brian Reese. Wave to your favorite driver. And as they come at you down the main straightaway, it's the Shaver's Oil Southern Nationals presented by Sunoco Race Fuels and Tennessee RV Super Center here at Scranton Motor Speedway. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here they are. Back straightaway, they're coming at you now. Same thing, wave your hands and caps in the air, get the cell phone lights going. And wish him Godspeed for the next 51 trips around Screven Motor Speedway in the 18th annual Rebel Yell as they get ready to start to break them out. And we are going to get set to come to green. 51 laps, $10,000 up for grabs. The one to go signal has been shown, and we are coming to green next time by. Middleburg, Florida's Mark Whitener and Evans, Georgia native Brandon Overton set to bring them to green. The 18th annual Old Rebel Yell at Screven Motor Speedway. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime! They'll drag race to turn number one. Who's going to come out of there with the race lead? Overton drifts up to the high side of the racing surface. He's going to lead Whitener down the back straightaway and into turn number three. Dennis Franklin going to be third. Whitener, he'll fire the slider. Here comes Overton right underneath him. He'll lead lap number one. Overton with the lead. Whitener in second. Rambo rides in third. Kid Quick, Zach Mitchell sets in the fourth spot with the 101 of Casey Roberts in position number five. Mitchell very high right there. They're three wide for fourth off four. Roberts looking to grab the fourth spot from Kid Quick. He'll have that done down in a turn number one. Three laps in the books, fixing a complete lap number four right here. As Overton continuing to lead the way, a rim riding around the top side of Screven Motor Speedway here tonight. In the early going, Mark Whitener in second, Dennis Franklin is third, Casey Roberts holds down the fourth spot, Zach Mitchell fifth, Brian Connor is sixth. Starting to shape up for that third spot. Roberts trying to get racy with Rambo as they work off turn number four. Down the front straightaway, side by side. It's a dead heat for third down into turn number one. Put Casey Roberts behind Dennis Franklin here in the early going. Yes, Roberts on the move. Meanwhile, Overton setting sail out in front of this one. We'll have eight in the books right here as we get ready to start working a little slower traffic on lap number nine. Overton showing the way. First car he's going to have to put a lap down. Going to be the 14 of Brian Reese, and he'll clear him to the outside down into turn number one. Widener still holding down the second spot. Casey Roberts is third, Dennis Franklin fourth. Zach Mitchell in fifth, Brian Connor sixth, Shannon Buckingham in seventh, Donald McIntosh eighth, Michael Brown ninth, and the Super Duck Donald Bradshaw, the final car in the top 10 with 11 laps scored. Overton stretching the lead out, has about three quarters of a straightaway advantage over second place running Mark Whitener here. In the early stages of this one, he'll work around the 10 of Ryan Crane through turns one and two. Whitener holding down that second spot still. Roberts third, Franklin fourth. As Franklin starting to get a little bit of pressure now from fellow South Carolina State driver Zach Mitchell. But Mitchell leaves the bottom open. Here comes Connor. But Connor not able to make the move for the five spot down into turn number one. Meanwhile, Overton works that high side. He'll set his sights on the Aussie, Craig Vosburg, and then get ready to try to put him a lap down. Down into turn number one. Not able to get it done yet as we got a Baker's Dozen. 13 in the books. 38 remain. And Overton making it look easy at this point, even though he's having a little bit of trouble in traffic right here. Widener in second, but Casey Roberts starting to close in on him. Franklin still third, Zach Mitchell fourth, or Franklin fourth, Mitchell in fifth, correction. Overton content to ride at the moment, but behind the slower cars of Craig Vosbergen and Brian Ligon. As we'll have 15 laps scored this time, 15 in the book, 36 remain. Overton will go to the bottom of Ligon there in turns of one and two down the back straightaway. He's going to clear Ligon now here off of turn four and set his sights on Vosburg and once again to try to put him a lap down. Whitener really hadn't gained much on him at this point, but Roberts is closed in on Whitener for the second spot as Franklin. And here comes Shannon Buckingham now up between cars. C Mitchell's gone to fourth. Shannon Buckingham, sixth. Brian Connor in fifth. Yes, we're about to see a lap number 20 get registered here momentarily. Overton still working to the outside of Osbergen. Yes, we've got 20 laps in the books, 20 down, 31 remain. Overton still shows the way. Widener in second. Correction, Casey Roberts now in second. Roberts around Widener. They're back on lap number 19. So Casey Roberts holds down the second position now. Going to set his sights on race leader Brandon Overton and try to run him down, but nothing doing at this point. Overton on point, Roberts second. Widener third, Mitchell is fourth, Buckingham in fifth. That is your top five here at this point in the contest. And put Buckingham into the fourth spot now. Buckingham will go to position number four. As we start to close in on the halfway mark of this one. And Overton continuing to set a torrid pace up at the point. Trying to get around the C9 of Steve Casebolt and put him a lap down. Casey Roberts holds down the runner-up spot still. As Mark Widener continues to ride in the third position, halfway to the house, he'll show it right there. 26 in the books. Brandon Overton, the race leader, the Schaefer Oil top 10, or at least we'll get the top five for you. Overton the leader, Roberts second, Widener is third, Buckingham fourth. And Michael Brown now in fifth. So Michael Brown in the 24D has entered his machine into the top five here in this contest. Overton still leading the way, taking a 116 machine off turn number two down the back straightaway. Casey Roberts rides in second, Mark Widener third, Shannon Buckingham fourth, Michael Brown fifth. Here at this stage of the contest. As field working lap number 30 now. There'll be 30 in the books this time by. 30 down when Overton crosses right here. 30 in the books. 21 to go. If you're playing blackjack, it's the number you want. But right now you got 21 laps left here in this one. Overton, he has done his damage around the top most of the time. Jumps to the bottom right there. Roberts has closed ground just a little bit on the leader. Widener holding down the third spot. Buckingham in fourth. Brown in fifth. And that is your top five. As Overton trying to work to the outside of some of the slower traffic, and Casey Roberts has also stepped to the high side here. 33 laps about to go up, 18 laps to go. Overton will bring him down here off turn number four, trying to clear the 2X of John Henderson. He's got that done down into turn number one. Casey Roberts has definitely closed the gap as Overton has struggled in traffic here just a little bit around the halfway mark of this one. And Roberts now hung up behind the slower car of Craig Vosbergen. As Overton continuing to show the way out in front. Overton riding behind the one of Brent Dixon. He's got the car of John Henderson between him as Casey Roberts squeezes past Craig Vosbergen now, trying to run down race leader Brandon Overton. As we've got 37 laps in the books, 14 to go for the leader. And Overton with one slower car between himself and the second place machine of Casey Roberts. Now make it two cars as he's around the one of Brent Dixon. Racetrack looks like it put some rubber down around that bottom groove. And usually that's where you want to be, but Overton trying to put his car up on the top shelf and drive his way around the slower traffic. And he's got two slower cars right now between himself and second place running Casey Roberts. Mark Whitener holding down the third spot. He's got Shannon Buckingham on his back bumper in fourth and Michael Brown fifth. As when we come by this time, and a problem's on the leader. Brandon Overton may have had a tire let go, and caution, the caution flag is out. Oh my. Understand he got into the outside retaining wall up in turn number four there. So I'm sure he's going to be headed to the attention of his crew over in the work area. See what shakes out here as it looks like we are getting set to come back to green. Roberts will bring them down off turn number four, and here we go. And we got caution. Caution is out. It's Brian Ligon's machines. I believe that's the four of Ligon. Yes, that is the four of Brian Ligon. His machine says stopped up to the outside of turn. Caution lights are out. We get set to come back to green. A dozen left to decide the 18th annual Rebel Yell. Fast track late models. You need to be in staging and ready to go, please. Casey Roberts set to wind him up and pull the trigger on him off turn number four. Here we go. Buckingham trying to get around Whitener for the second spot here on the restart. And Dennis Franklin, who was up to, is in six up between cars, trying to grab fourth. Buckingham looking for the lead on Roberts. Not able to get it done, though. Buckingham going to challenge Roberts now for the top spot as they race through turns of three and four. Roberts with the lead, Buckingham in second, Whitener in third. Dennis Franklin and Zach Mitchell go at it for fourth and fifth. Roberts on a point, Buckingham second, Whitener third. Franklin and Mitchell still fourth and fifth, Brown sixth, McIntosh seventh. Bales eighth, Overton is up tonight. Buckingham with eight to go. Roberts slips a bit. Does this open the door for Buckingham? Roberts hangs on to the race lead. They're side by side for it off turn number four. Roberts challenging. Buckingham getting repeatedly challenging Roberts for the race lead. Roberts and Buckingham, they're going to try to settle the issue amongst themselves. With six to go. Six laps remaining. Roberts the leader, Buckingham second. Whitener third, Franklin fourth. And Ross Bales flexing his muscles late in this one, the 87. He is up to fifth with five to go. There'll be four to go this time for Casey Roberts, looking for his second win in the Rebel Yell. Buckingham second, Whitener third, Franklin fourth, Bales fifth, Brown sixth, McIntosh seventh, and Overton eighth. And this is really going to tighten up a points lead, no doubt about it. As the top three were separated by 12 coming into this one. We'll have two laps to go this time off of turn number four. Two to go for leader Casey Roberts. He is going to encounter some traffic before it's said no. We should see the white flag right here off turn number four. One lap to go in the 18th annual Rebel Yell. Roberts down the back straightaway for the final time and into turn three. Off of turn number four, Toccoa, Georgia's Casey Roberts is now a two-time Rebel Yell winner at Screven Motor Speedway. Shannon Buckingham will come home in second. Mark Widener will finish third. Dennis Franklin fourth. And Ross Bales completes the top five. And back in the pit area here at Screven Motor Speedway, we've got tonight's 18th annual Rebel Yell winner, Toccoa, Georgia's Casey Roberts. And Casey, we spoke for just a second out on the front straightaway, but again, I got to ask you, you rolled up to second right there, right around the midway point of the event, and at that time, the race leader, Brandon Overton, got to struggling just a little bit with some traffic. You were able to close in on him, and then he has the issue with the tire. Prior to that happening, do you think you had anything for Overton up to that point?
I think on a clean racetrack, definitely not. But in loud traffic, you never know what happens. Them guys have definitely been running good. So we just had a good night. It was just meant for us to win there, I guess. And so I hate that for them. They've been doing a real good job this year. And we've lost them that way, too. So we'll definitely take it.
And I know you've not had a bad season by any means, but it's kind of been a yo-yo season for Casey Roberts and his race team, kind of up and down, and you've had some really good runs, but you haven't had the end results to show for it. This really got to be a pretty satisfying win for this race team here tonight.
Oh, definitely. It's a good shot in the arm there. We've, had a good chance to win last night. We just need a little bit of luck, and we've definitely been off a little bit, but we just come down and went back to what works there. So, it was a good night for us there, and just thank the good Lord. And I got to thank Cushman Paint and Body, M&S Concrete, and CNH Paving, Penske Racing Shocks, Hoosier Racing Tire, VP Race Fuel, Schaefer Racing Oil, Clements Engine, and this Whack Pack here. They done a great job on the car, and Matt and my wife, and they've been working their butts off, and it's just a tough deal here, and just glad we got it done tonight.
Did it surprise you when Buckingham kind of showed you the nose there through three and four with about nine or ten laps to go, or did that rattle you any at all, or did you just kind of stay focused on the task at hand and be sure you hit your marks there the rest of the race?
Yeah, we didn't fire up that great. We went with some hard tires there, and we done ran out of saps too. So, but we just didn't fire off good. It took a while there to get going. I seen him down there, and my wife telling me there to get down, but I didn't want to, pinch them off. We've always raced each other clean, and with just a few laps to go there, I just, when I thought I was clean enough, I just got down there, back down there where it kind of rubbered up a little bit, and hard tires started taking back off pretty good once they got a little heat in them, and we were able to pull away a little bit there at the end. So just a good night, congratulations to them guys, just look forward to going over to Rome tomorrow.
Well, congratulations. You're now a two-time Rebel Yell winner, and we'll see you at Rome Speedway tomorrow night.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
And a few words with second-place finisher tonight in the 18th annual Rebel Yell here at Screven Motor Speedway, Shannon Buckingham. And, Buck, another great night for you, another podium finish. Had that restart there. You was able to get to second and actually put some heat on Roberts there for the lead there with about 10 or so to go. Do you feel like could you have done anything different right there to maybe got around Casey and kick the door down and got that first $10,000 career victory?
Oh, absolutely. I could have run in our door, slammed him, but I'm not going to do that. Casey, I've never seen Casey race anyone that way. He's never raced me that way, and I'm not going to race him that way. I will say maybe one more, and I was going to try to slide up in front of him, but I felt like I was in the position where I could have done that, and if he would have stayed composed, he would have turned back under me because I was about maxed out on traction. I'd had to shear quite a bit to have done that, and I don't think I could have held him off. But just really happy for my guys, JC and Jacob and my dad and my wife and Roger and everybody that's been here. Man, we've worked so hard, and this thing, it can get a little grueling. The heat's been pretty rough. We've tore some stuff up, so we've worked hard. They've worked hard. It's actually we've had more crew than we've had drivers for this week with my teammate Robbie being gone. So it's been a little easier on me. I've been able to kick back just a little and rely on them more. So it's been a lot of fun. It's been relaxing. But, yeah, I'm just super happy with the Tennessee RB team. We're gaining. I really thought we were going to get that one tonight. I've only been here a couple times, but I like this place. I'm pretty good bottom feeder. That's where I like to live. So, you know, I hate Brandon had that bad luck, but you know, I figured that the tires might be an issue tonight, you know, and he likes to get up there and go hard. And I knew we weren't going hard. I knew we weren't spinning tires. So I thought if it did become an issue that we would be in good shape. But, man, I'm just super stoked. We've had a good time. I think that bumped us way up in the points. So we're heading on for tomorrow night.
That segues me into my next thing that I was going to ask you. There was 12 points separating yourself, Overton and McIntosh coming in tonight, and I don't know how it's going to break out. We'll know more about it tomorrow when we get to Rome. But you finishing second. Overton was seventh. McIntosh eighth. We've got a real tight points battle going to Rome tomorrow night.
Yeah, that should put us either tied or maybe in the lead. So I'm pretty excited about that. Of course, you know, Brandon's been on a tear, and he's going to be really good at Rome. The last time we were there, we were really good too. You know, we lost brakes in the feature. So I like that place, and we're gravitating back towards home. So I'm excited, man. Anyway, it falls out. Brandon and Donald, they're great guys, and I want to race with them. I'm just feel blessed to have that opportunity. Thanks to, you know, Roger for giving me that chance. And so we're happy. You know, I mean, I loved to got that 10 tonight, but I'm super, super satisfied.
Congratulations. We'll see you tomorrow night at Rome. Yeah, and we're here with a gentleman to finish third tonight in the 18th Annual Rebel Yell with the Schaefer's Oil Southern National Series at Scranton Motor Speedway, Middleburg, Florida's Mark Whitener. And, young man, really good job out there tonight. You look really good early on, won that heat race, and put yourself up front to start this thing. And pretty tough racetrack here at Scranton, but you brought that thing home in third place tonight. Congratulations. Tell us about your race.
Yeah, we had a fast car all night. We had a fast car last night and got a little mishap. And you know, we had a pretty much a third place car tonight and a third place car, you know, last night. And you know, I just like to thank these guys. They just put me in it for this weekend, and just like to thank them for giving me the opportunity to come race Southern Nationals with Ray. So I'd like to thank everybody that makes it happen.
And I know you do a majority of your racing down in the Sunshine State of Florida, so it's kind of got to be a breath of fresh air, maybe a shot in the arm when you get in a situation, even if it's just a one-off weekend deal, to be able to come up and go to some different places. And I don't know how many times you may have raced here in the past, but you look really, really comfortable in that race car, and you may want to stay in that thing for a while because you're getting better as the weekends went on here.
Yeah. Hopefully they let me back in it. We've came here a few times, and we're really happy with the car. I drive the Longhorn, you know, so it's a Longhorn also. So we're real comfortable with that. We put our shocks on it and got the thing tuned in pretty good the way I like to drive. So, we was getting better and better. And, if the rain holds off, we're going to go to Rome and see if we can get a little better. Maybe we can pull off a victory before we leave and go home this weekend.
Very good. And I got to ask you, anything, now that you've had time to reflect on this thing, anything you think you could have done different where you could have been maybe a first or second place car tonight?
No. Maybe not trying so hard. Yeah, I think I may have been overdriving a little bit. Some of it's me. I ain't been in a super in a couple years, so some of it was probably me and Justin on the car. I mean, this is the second night in the car, so you know, but they're all Longhorn, so I ain't got no excuse there. I'm just saying it's the new team, you know, we're just trying to feel things out and see where this goes. Maybe we'll be able to go run some bigger races, bigger money races, and continue this deal whenever they want to race. I don't think they want to race all the time, so maybe it'll work out.
Well, best of luck to you tomorrow night at Rome Speedway, young man.
Thank you all. Thank you.